All right, so what is MOVEit? MOVEit is an open source software library for manipulation using robot arms that are either fixed rigidly to a certain location or mounted on top of a mobile robot. MOVEit is integrated with ROS. The developers and maintainers of MOVEit ensure that there is a binary installation of MOVEit available for each ROS installation. That is, MOVEit can be installed via this command. In this course, we will mainly use MOVEit to plan motions for the fixed serial link manipulators, the UR10 and the UR5 robots in our factory. But MOVEit can also be used to integrate information from 2D and 3D sensors to achieve additional functionality such as perception and navigation. However, we will not be exploring those options in this basic course. In essence, MOVEit is a software platform to configure and use various functionalities associated with manipulation. Let's recall again the different functional modules associated with manipulation that we saw in the earlier video. We learned that in a broad sense, manipulation can be achieved via successfully combining different functional modules, namely environment sensing, motion planning, collision checking, trajectory processing, and motion execution. Thanks to some great efforts by different research institutions, faculties, industries, and labs across the world, we have open source software implementations of all of these modules available. For example, we could use Intel RealSense or the Ensenso 3D camera or several other sensors for environment sensing and perception using their corresponding ROS packages. For motion planning, we can use some of the well-known libraries such as OMPL or CHOMP and so forth. Those who are interested in what these libraries actually do, you can look them up on the web pages listed below. For collision checking, we can use the Flexible Collision Library, FCL, or the Bullet Physics Library, and so forth. For trajectory processing, we can use the Iterative Parabolic Time Parameterization, or the Time Optimal Path Parameterization, and so on. And finally, we can execute the resulting trajectories on a simulated robot or on the real robot using the various robot drivers that are developed and supported by the ROS Industrial Consortium and others. Wow, that's plenty of software options we have. And remember, I have only listed two examples here per module. But if you look on the ROS Wiki, you will be spoiled for choices. But such a luxury comes at the cost of understanding how to interface each of these modules to work together to achieve manipulation. And that can be a tedious task. It would be nice if someone or some software package would do this for us and make it all really easy to use for us, isn't it? And that's exactly what MOVEit does. Amazing, isn't it? It sounds simple when you just look at this overview, but as you might have guessed, there is a lot going on under the hood in MOVEit. MOVEit takes care of so many different things for us. First, it maintains information consistency between our ROS application and all those different functional modules such that they can work together. It integrates the kinematics of our robot setups to the motion planning libraries. Note that the planning algorithms are not only implemented to work with robot manipulators specifically. They are implemented in an abstract manner, and MOVEit makes sure that those algorithms can work with robot arms. MOVEit also takes care of the interaction between collision checking and motion planning to report and request alternative plans in case the initial plans from the planners were unsafe due to collisions. MOVEit accounts for ensuring the physical limits of a robot, such as the minimum and maximum joint angles, are respected while planning and executing motions. It keeps track of where a robot currently is with respect to its surroundings so that any dynamically changing aspects in the environment are also accounted for to a certain degree. MOVEit also takes care of communicating with the robot hardware or simulation and notify the ROS application from a user once the desired manipulation task is complete. Phew, that's a lot of work that MOVEit does for us. Thank you, MOVEit, and its development and maintenance team. And the nice thing is, as a MOVEit user, what we get to see is just one ROS node called the move group. This is where all the processing and coordination associated with the various steps that we saw before happens. And to use all those functionalities, the move group node provides us with several ROS service and action APIs that can be used in our specific ROS application. We will look into some of these APIs as we go along in this week. To effectively use the move group node, we need to configure it with a few parameters. The first being the robot description parameter, which is the robot URDF or Zucchero model we built in week 2. The robot semantic description, which we will see shortly, and some parameter files specifying different entities like robot joint limits, the motion planner options, and so on. That's indeed very nice that we have to do so little as users to get so much out of MoveIt. But how do we set up all these parameters? We do that with an amazing graphical user interface called the MoveIt Setup Assistant. Let's see how to use it in the next video.